And in business, South Africa has now fallen into its second recession in 2 years, even as President Cyril Ramaphosa's attempt to revive growth continues. The economy contracted 1.4% in the fourth quarter of 2019, according to official statistics released on Tuesday. Now, this far outpaced analysts' forecasts of a 0.2% decline. The contraction came after a 0.8% drop in economic output during the previous quarter, leading to South Africa's second recession, defined as two quarters of negative growth since 2018. I am now joined by Anelisa Tuswa in Cape Town, South Africa. Hello, Anelisa. Now, what's your take on the recently released report indicating that South Africa is in its second recession in 2 years?
I don't think the news of the recession came as a shock for many of us, whether you're an economist or just an average South African. I think we're all aware that the economy didn't do quite well in 2019. I mean, we saw some of the largest industries, including manufacturing, mines, and even just the retail sector, which usually outperforms all the other sectors, especially in the end of the year period, because a lot of people are actually buying stuff online or just doing their Christmas shoppings and even the Black Friday sales. So we are all aware that the 2019 economic year wasn't a great one. However, I have to say we are quite shocked by how large the economy contracted on. I mean, we fell by 1.4%, which is quite a huge number, because usually we normally go along with the predictions, and Bloomberg, Reuters, and all the other economic sectors had actually predicted a contrast of about 0.5, if not 0.6.
And what should we expect in the coming months?
Economic growth and business investment and opportunities really go hand in hand. So if the economy is not growing, then it means business won't really have consumers. Consumers in the economy won't have enough money to spend, and a business with no consumer means there's not enough profit. So really, I think the outlook for businesses might need to start outlining or just restructuring their production lines. And in terms of the outlook, I think the IMF had predicted had quite not really positive predictions for us, but they have assumed that we are going to grow at least by a percentage. I think after this recession, we really are not going to make it above the percentage. I highly doubt that this year we'll see anything more than 2% growth for the full year, or even just edging closer to the required 4%. And I mean, in order for the economy to grow and create more jobs and better opportunities, South Africa is going to need about 4 to 5% growth, and we're battling now to even just get above 1%.
And how would this affect business growth and projected forecast for South Africa?
I think the future of SA, especially for 2020, is quite bleak, if I'm being honest. I think we're seeing an unemployment that is edging closer to the 30% mark, which is quite a big number. Economic projections for the rest of the year, I think the Reserve Bank had predicted about 1.2%, and I have a feeling that in 2 weeks' time, when you go into the MPC, they'll downgrade that projection, because also the IMF had predicted about 0.5%.
Thank you, Anelisa, for that.